I know thy works and tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich. Welcome to the Black Excellence and Abundance Channel.
The Freedom Georgia Initiative. With consistent deaths of Black people at the hands of those in place to protect and serve the citizens of this United States, there are a great number of Black people who vehemently believe that the only way they will receive freedom, justice, and equality is to separate from white society. Back in the 1960s, the Kerner Commission discovered that in the U.S., there are two separate but equal societies in America. Now, in 2020, a Black Georgia-based realtor who had to receive therapy following the horrific murder of Ahmaud Arbery in Georgia back in February of 2020 is now following that ideal to create a peaceful, safe community for Black people. Ashley Scott and Renee Walters founded the Freedom Georgia Initiative for the importance of general and casual safety for Black people in the United States. Scott said, "We are dealing with deep-rooted issues that will require more than protesting in the streets. It will take for us as a people, as Atlanta rapper and activist Killer Mike so eloquently put, to plot, plan, strategize, organize, and mobilize." So that's what I and my good friend Renee Walters, an entrepreneur and investor, did. The Freedom Georgia Initiative's Facebook page say that they hope to be an innovative model for self-sufficiency, environmental sustainability, and cooperative economics among Black, Indigenous, people of color communities across the African diaspora globally. A group of 19 Black families purchased almost 97 acres of land in Tomsboro, Georgia, to plant the seeds for a thriving new city. In an op-ed published on Blavity, founder of the Freedom Georgia Initiative, Ashley Scott, said, "I sought counseling from a Black therapist after the tragic death of Ahmaud Arbery, a young Black man who was killed while out for a jog in Georgia in February 2020. And therapy helped. It helped me to realize that what we as Black people are suffering from is racial trauma. We are dealing with systemic racism." After Ashley Scott and Renee Walters launched their Freedom Georgia Initiative, Scott and Walters attended local city council and zoning meetings. Then she and 19 other families came together to purchase the large amount of land in Tomsboro, Georgia. History has shown that to wait for others to prioritize the safety and protection of Black people has proven to be futile. As a result, many of us have taken the initiative for our own economic and environmental destiny. Scott continues, "We figured we could try to fix a broken system, or we could start fresh. We could start a city that could be a shining example of being the change you want to see. We wanted to be more involved in creating the lives we really want for our Black families, and maybe, just maybe, create some generational wealth for ourselves by investing in the land. Ground has already been broken for a location for the new Black Wall Street, one of many to come." Scott plans to equip their newly owned land with Black farmers, vendors, suppliers, and contractors. She says that her vision is for other Black families to gather and create independent communities to amass land, to develop our own affordable housing, to build our own food systems, build manufacturing and supply chains, build our own homeschools, communities, build our own banks and credit unions, our own cities and police departments. She would like us to begin to tax ourselves, vote in a mayor, a city council that you can trust, and overall a safe community for Black people. Our own sanctuary cities, owned, operated, and controlled by us. Scott plans to equip their newly owned land with Black farmers, vendors, suppliers, and contractors. The Freedom Georgia Initiative's website says, "Our aim is to be a premier recreational, educational, and cultural destination for Black families across the African diaspora. We welcome you, your family, and all Black allies to support us in our vision to be the change we want to see. We encourage you all to be inspired to create these independent, self-sustaining communities, because politics as usual isn't the answer. Something new has to happen." Ladies and gentlemen, our own sanctuary cities, the new Black Wall Street. If they did it then, we can do it now.
The Black Excellence and Abundance Channel, where Black history is every day. Thanks for watching. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe. And as always, thou art rich. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe. And as always, thou art rich.